proceed along our track, getting geology along the way.
Roger, we concur.
Hey, Julia, man, I'll come over and help you with that thing, yeah? Okay, Houston, did you copy that switch number 5 is clockwise and safe?
Roger, I now copy switch 5 clockwise and safe.
Okay, we're going to arm the motorbike. Unlock and pull, safety rods. Hold it down.
Alan, this is Houston. After arming the motorbike, we'd like you to proceed back in the general direction of the LEM and selecting a suitable area en route, collect the comprehensive sample, and try to pick up a football-sized rock on the way. Over.
Okay, that's our intent, Houston.
And I'll give you periodic reports on how much time you've got left until you have to be back at the Mesa.
It's a little off level now. Yeah, I'll re-level it for it. Good. I could re-level it right now. I'm pushing on and back. I'm up to a good spot for this.
Okay.
Keeping the safety rods are out of the border back.
Roger. Alan, add mark 4 hours into the EVA. Alan, add mark 4 hours into the EVA.
Okay.
With the half hour extension, we're working into a 4 hour and 45 minute EVA duration. Alan, would you confirm that you have the extension handle off of the bumper geophone anchor?
I will have it when I leave here, so we don't have it yet.
Roger.
Okay, Houston, the mortar pack is lined with the bubble tangent to the inner ring. And I'm going to arm it down. It's pointed almost, almost due north, a little bit to the west of north. I guess Alan's photographs will allow you to get that exactly.
Roger, bubble tangent to inner ring and almost due north.
Yeah. It's tangent to the inner ring on the northwest side.
Okay.
Okay, both arming switches are on the mortar pack. Switch number 5 is going back counterclockwise.
Okay, stand clear. Okay, switch 5 is RF.
Okay, you got the thing here.
15 feet back when it's up. 15 feet away when that cable's only 10 feet long.
Roger, we copy, and you got the safety right, the two switches on the back, and switch 5, beautiful.
That's from. And I have a extension handle, and I'm stuck down after all of them. You're a different mode of traveling than carrying that barbell. Andrew, I'm copying into Sample. We're about a third of the way back to the lab. I'm not found in the area exactly what I want, so I have drawn a circle which is approximately 2 meters in radius. And I'm going to pick the surface rocks from that and a sampling of the surface finds from that area.
Roger, Al.
And I've documented this location with a locator shot back to the lab and to the oil ship.
Roger, Al.
Okay, Al, need some help there.
Okay, Al, beautiful. We can see you coming down the ladder right now. It looks like you're about on the bottom step. And on the surface. Not bad for it, old man.
Okay, you're right. Al is on the surface, and it's been a long way, but we're here. I can see the reason we have a tilt is because we landed on the slope. The landing gear struts appear to be about evenly depressed.
Roger out.
And moving around, getting familiar with the surface. Surface in which the forward foot pad landed is extremely soft. As a matter of fact, it's in a small depression. The soil is so soft that it comes up all the way to the top of the foot pad. And even fold it over the side to some degree. The same is true of the brush wire strut.
Roger.
Okay, we'll move on over. Take a look at Frau Mauro. Take a look at concrete, or I should say, which is right where it should be, and is a very impressive sight.
And Terry, this is Houston. You are go for two-man EVA. Over.
Roger, Houston. Thank you. And continuing, we can see the boulders on the rim. It looks as though we have a good traverse route up to the top of Cone. I can see Cone Ridge going along to the north. It's very apparent. And I'm moving over to a Chesta Mesa.
Roger, Al.
Yeah.
Houston, finishing up my circuit breaker check. I'll be ready to go out shortly.
Roger, Ed.
Okay, Ed, we can see you coming down the ladder now. Roger, bottom step.
At Houston, finishing up my circuit breaker check. I'll be ready to go out shortly.
Roger, Ed.
Hey, the base has adjusted. Bring over to remove the net blanket.
Mitchell coming out now. Shepard tilting the mace up slightly now to get the net, which is a pull cart, out for under it.
Okay, Ed, we can see you coming down the ladder now.
Yeah.
Very great to be coming down. Roger, bottom step.
FF
check, very easy to do. Little push and just bring right up.
I guess we got there with those lightweight units.
Yeah, sure glad they did too. That's great.
Now, this is Houston. Have you released the net yet, sir?
He's releasing it now. Okay, Houston, the net is finally clear of the mesa. Well, I'm going to come over. How about getting my antenna out before I lose the storm here in a minute?
Okay.
Back over at the corner or something.
Can you just drop this baby over here?
Okay.
The net will be placed on one of the foot pads.
It is bright up, son, isn't it? Okay, if you'll stop here a minute, I'll get you in and out. Good.
come by one. Okay, there you go. Now deployed.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, this one, the Mesa has been slowed on the foot to line foot pad.
Roger out.
Yeah. And going back to adjust the Mesa. No doubt is very great after this crushing 116 oil, Houston.
Roger. Shepard now adjusting the television.
And looking at Cone Crater, where I was looking a short time ago, it doesn't appear there's going to be any trouble getting the shot up Cone Crater.
Backup crew copies.
They got a chip on. I know they would. They knew the troops on the ground would be glad to hear that.
Backup crew here in Mission Control.
See, yeah, here comes the lens cap.
Yeah, Mesa Blanket is coming off here, but...
Oh, record, Mesa Blanket.
You'll lose television for a moment. Okay, that's beautiful.
The foil coating and they're off the Mesa.
Zoom in a little more. Let's try 40 here. Okay, and on the F stop, Al, we'd like to stop it down one additional stop. That's towards the higher numbers.
Okay, it's going from 22 to 44, and I'll zoom it in to 40. Stand by.
Okay, hold the zoom there, and the position looks good also.
Okay, how about the F-stop? If the F-stop sounds back for you.
Alice, if Houston, see if you can stop it down a little more. Run it up, run the diaphragm ring up against the stop there. It's still a little bright.
Okay, it's right up against the stop.
Roger, stand by.
Houston, I request you go to peak control.
Okay, going to peak.
satisfactory?
Okay, Al, now we'd like to open it up to F-22.
Okay, this is the next ejection to F-22. There you go.
Roger.
This is Houston, would you confirm that you're at F-22 now?
Okay.
Alice, this is Houston, would you confirm that you're at F-22 now?
Okay.
Okay, I'm confirming that I'm at peak and I'm at F-22. Television adjustments, the 230 position, approximately 50 feet where the camera is slightly uphill. We see that the clam did, in fact, land on sort of a downslope.
Al, this is Houston.
In, almost the basin. Go ahead.
Roger, Al, this is Houston. We'd like to go back to average and F-44, stop it down all the way and then leave it there.
Okay, this is the last adjustment. 1944.
Roger, and back with zoom out to about 35.
And I'm going to average. And back to zoom out to 35. And how does that look?
Beautiful.
Okay, pressing on.
Yes, ma'am,
antenna.
Roger, press.
Again, continuing the soil is really fine here, very fine grain. And as we mentioned before, there are very few samples that can any size at all. Mostly 10 sample size and box of generally 1 to 2 inches or less.
Just so that you can see the test rushing turbo is deployed. EV is empty, and I'm putting the lateral temperatures in it now.
Roger, Ed, and you did leave the contingency sample on the ladder.
That's affirmative, that's where it is.
Yes, it looks as though we landed in a fairly rough place.
Yes, indeed it does. But it's not a fact you put your front landing gear into a hole.
We can't raise for both crew members. We're just off the ladder. Shepard 120, Mitchell 124, both reading now in the 70 to 85 range.
Yeah, Houston, I have the SWC up, just running up to the port.
Roger, Ed.
Still on your field of view,
Houston. That's
affirmative. Mitchell deploying the solar wind experiment now.
is in place.
Roger, Ed, at 114 plus 53 plus 48 GED. WC.
Houston, the LR cubed and coming off.
Roger, Ed. Houston, if you would, give us some commentary on how the legs go under the surface. We were driving more at forest penetration, and did you meet any rocks or anything like that?
I didn't attempt to run any kind of an experiment.
Roger, I copy.
Like that, I just...
Okay, can you restart? Oh,
up at the top. Okay? Yep. And you tilt it over toward me without dropping it, I'll get it up on for you.
All right.
Ready, flip? Okay, lower it on down.
Okay.
And done. Okay, set it up.
Okay. All kinds of freebies in today's simulation.
Roger, I got the boys in the back room working overtime.
You have.
Okay, there's drift way up there. And is that left now? Looks like it's getting close. Let me get on the glass. Okay, get a chance to the left a little more. Oh, wait a minute, could that change it a little bit?
Contingency sample into the ETB.
Okay.
boots? Is any appreciable dust flying up in these boots? I'd like to take all that dirt in there.
I didn't notice any on the TV.
Okay.
Did the contingency sample get in there?
That's affirmative. Would never dare for us to leave that one behind, Bruce. down.
Okay,
yeah.
Okay, give me a mark, Al, when you start using film.
I just started using film now.
Roger, are you on 24?
Roger 12. Hey, Ed, how are you doing, sir? Okay, Al, I've got it loaded. I'm about ready to start down with it now. Just another minute.
Before you start transferring, you want to verify contents in the ATV.
Okay, let me give you a call on a booth. I put in one black and white camera, a television camera, two hand flats, one EVAs, two 16 millimeter bags, and two maps.
Roger, did you get the 16 millimeter camera with mag attached? Flag is flying off the camera there, right?
How about that?
Al, this is Houston. We still show you off. Okay, you're coming back in now. Side of the lamp shadow. 20 feet. There you go. Beautiful, baby.
Okay. Okay. Camera going here.
Give me a mark.
Mark is ready.
Roger out.
How's this, Bruce? Look okay?
Roger, that's a good side. Yeah, you're going off camera to the right. Okay, that's good.
Yeah, let's see.
pointed? Yeah, I got the right. Okay, I went point a little bit further around that way. Yeah, I'll try to set mine as big as. Okay. Dead. Yeah, for the wind lag.
Okay, and which magazine are you using? Alpha what?
Indianapolis, Indiana.
Roger, Indianapolis, Indiana, but that was my line.
What's your TV cable? Thank you. Yes, sir, cable both. Got them both. Back up. Try it again.
About 3 minutes remaining on that magazine, Claremont, California.
Right, we won't change it. Okay, I'm going to press on out for the TV fam, Houston. Right. And while Ed is doing that, I was going to proceed with photographing the landing gear.
Roger.
Just about to land.
You're using Indianapolis, Indiana.
Okay, Houston, I will, for my first sector for PAM, I'll point a little bit more to the south.
Okay, we want to go to zoom of 25 on this.
That seems to run around this bowl that we're sitting in. It appears to be a ridge. It runs down from what we call the old nameless to the south, and it runs through the west. It seems to be roughly circular, but of course we could be a little bit deceived at this point on that score. The little rise you see in front of us is the rise that's shown on the map. The craters are on the map. Since I don't have it handy, I'd have to get to the coordinates later, but I think you already know them. They're about 150 feet and east of west of the wind. Go ahead.
Roger, you're going to spend several seconds describing each of these locations here. After the camera steadies out, you might just as well zoom out a ways, and we'll pick up some features at random on higher magnification and zoom back in when you go on to the next 45-degree sector.
Okay. And I've moved around to the next sector now, and it's looking down over what we used to call cloverleaf, although it's not obvious from here what the cloverleaf was. There is a fairly significant crater, about 250 to 300 yards out. And I'll try to come bring it in for you.
Yeah, you're doing fine. Keep zooming if you got any left. Well centered.
Okay, let's zoom all the way.
Okay, beautiful. Okay, beautiful.
Okay, that crater is it's kind of in a low spot, but it's not the lowest spot in this depth that we're in. The lowest spot we will pick up in our next sector.
Okay, bring her back in.
Close it because you won't be able to see it. Okay? Now, another sector to the right.
Roger.
Almost down sun.
All right, we got your shadow.
And, okay, in the very low spot, the deepest part, I guess, of what we were calling cloverleaf before, although I did not realize how deep that depression was, and I still don't quite.
Okay, zoom out while you're talking.
Can't quite get the relief in my mind because it is so different than what I expected. But what you're looking at now, this deep part, is to the south of Dublin, and it's probably 75 to 100 feet below where we are.
You're aimed up a little high.
From the far side to above it. Okay, how's that now?
A lot better. Hey, you don't need to stop talking when I talk if you can do both at once.
Okay. I have a little trouble listening to you and talking at you, too. That's polite. Okay. I'm bringing it back in. I'm coming around to the west-northwest. And you should be able to see in the distance Dublin crater. And I've lost it now because of the sun angle. But it's just about on the near horizon. There are three mounds, three ridges. The near side, the nearest one, the ridge that Dublin is on, and then the far horizon. And I'm bringing it on out for you. Dublin is on the second hill that you see.
Roger, we can see the ridges, and I can see a crater that probably is Dublin.
Okay. We'll zoom back in and move on around, but I think Gal's about to finish up his task over there.
Negative, I'm still working at 8 o'clock.
So.
And I just wonder how come McCandless has the audacity to presume that we're wrong about Dublin crater.
Very presumptuous. Okay, Bruce, I'm coming around one more sector. And you should be able, I'm going to move it just a little bit more. You should be able to see the large rock, the four or five rocks I was talking about
in my discussion before we got out of the lamp. And now I'll zoom in on those if I... May.
Yes, please.
Here we go.
Okay, now point the camera down a degree or two.
How's that?
Beautiful. You might come right a degree or so. I see the small rocks off to the right. Okay. What's that object in profile on the horizon?
Mentioned a quadruplet chain of craters.
Point it down a little.
They're right here in front of me. Okay. The quadruplet chain of craters starts right here in front of me. It's halfway between the rock and myself.
You're getting all sky.
Here. Now, there are quite a few. Let me zoom back in again.
Roger. Okay, hold it.
Okay, how's that now?
Good.
Okay, there's a soft quadruplet crater, and then there's the next one, and the next one, and the largest one.
Roger. Okay, I probably better go back to zoom 25 and press on with the panorama.
Okay, I'm at zoom 25. And I'm looking almost due north now. I'll swing back around and pan from our rocks. There's the rocks we were looking at. Heading slowly to the north. You can now see the undulation, the ridges that I was talking about.
Roger.
There's not a level portion out here that's more than a few square meters. And you can see at least three ridges between us and the horizon. Now I'll zoom in out here once more. As you see, it's close ahead what's up there. Another pile of rocks, more ridges.
You're pointing at the sky.
Okay.
That's better.
Need a gun sight on this thing.
Sure do.
Is that better?
Yeah, the horizon is about one quarter of the way up.
Okay.
Beautiful. Beautiful.
Okay, Houston, Al is finished with the documentation, counter 110.
Roger, Al, 110, Indianapolis, Indiana. And Ed, a frame or two ago, it looked like one of those rocks was split right down the middle. Did you notice that, too?
I don't think it is. It may be, it may look like it from there. We'll go by there later on.
Roger. Press on with the TV panorama. We're about 2 minutes behind timeline at this point, Ed. And you're looking at the sky again. Bring it down. Okay. Okay, Ed, we're recording all this on videotape so that it only takes a relatively brief period of time looking at the scene that we can play it back frame at a time later on. Back to 25. you reading me?
Eddie, you reading Houston?
Ed?
I can't reading anybody.
Okay. Ed, this is Houston. We're not reading you.
Okay, Bruce, now you are. I hit the transmit switch to off.
You're loud and clear.
The horizon that you see in this view is a north flank leading up to Cone Crater. It's over a mile away, a mile and a half away. I'll give a quick zoom in on it. And then I can't go any closer to the sun right now.
Okay, you're looking at the sky again.
Okay, we're...
Okay. There you go.
Beautiful.
Okay, we're at the time to deploy the med ed if you want to swing it out back around.
Okay.
Okay, we're at the time to deploy the med ed if you want to swing it out back around.
Okay. Bruce, what was the zoom setting you wanted?
Okay, let's try about 45 there. We'd like to get the flag in at the right extremity and the plus Y, if we can, at the left extremity. Hold that. Pan left about 2 degrees. Left 2 degrees. Okay, that looks... Okay. Yeah, back it out about to 40 on the zoom. Yeah, that's good.
Okay.
Okay, Al and Ed, if we could get you both in the field of view there for a minute, we've got a message for you. Okay, you're looking lovely, Coops. Why don't you take a pair and let me pass a message to you?
Okay,
okay. Okay. We're very pleased a few minutes ago to receive a phone call here in Mission Control from President Nixon. He asked me to extend to you and to Stu his best congratulations. He said that like millions of people all over the world, he is an astronaut watcher at this time. The picture is coming in very well at the White House, he said. The President said he knew how many thousands of people had worked on this mission, without whom men would not be walking safely on the moon. He asked that I wish the Apollo entire team well. The President said he was proud of you and proud of them. He sent you a wire just before the flight wishing you Godspeed, and he wishes you well on your return flight. The President also asked me to invite you to the White House for dinner and to spend the weekend at Camp David with your families after the mission is completed. Over.
That's fine, Dick. Thanks very much. And we appreciate those kind words.
Thank you, Dick, and convey our thanks to the President, please.
Roger, will do. I don't think Stu got this, but we'll see. He gets it later.
Okay. Hey, you ready? Get the wheels first. Okay. Hey, you ready? Get the wheels first. Hey. Hey.
Wheels out.
Tires shut up.
180, gear down and locked.
Both tires are inflated properly on the mat.
Roger out.
Okay, let's put it there. Let's get the flight power cell up here. There we go.
Well, let's see. Where's that district again?
Yeah.
Currently worth mentioning.
Okay. deployed properly.
Roger.
Looks like it's in good shape.
Okay, I'll get a camera.
Okay, if you want to see this right here, I'll move around to put the TV camera on the scientific equipment.
And Terry Houston, we'd like to get an EMU status report at this point. Terry Houston, we'd like to get an EMU status report at this point.
Okay, CDR is 3.7. And reading 72. No flags, I'm on low flow and in good shape.
Good.
And the LFB is 3.7. And reading 67%, low flow, low cooling, and feeling great.
Roger.
TV cameras covered and proceeding to the rear of the limb to observe the deployment of the all set.
Roger.
Okay, just in the covers coming off the lens now. Okay, just in the covers coming off the lens now.
Roger, Al, are you all the way back at the 30-foot position there? 6 o'clock 30?
No, it's not. It's about 30 right there, I'd say.
Okay, our picture is moving around a lot. You're going to have to set it down and let it stabilize before we can tell you anything about it. Okay, what zoom are you on?
Trying to find a level spot, Bruce.
Roger.
On the side of the hill, as you probably have heard. And it may not stay. May tip over.
Can you poke one of the legs into the surface there? It's a pretty flimsy tripod, I realize.
Now.
Okay, what zoom are you on?
Okay, how's that?
We need to back off the zoom some.
Yeah, I think we'll have to.
Okay. Yeah, wrong way.
Okay, Bruce, can you see the bay?
I can see your hands very clearly. We seem to be close to my... Okay, hold that zoom, Al. Roger, looks good.
Okay.
Beautiful. Beautiful.
Okay, the door... Cab car door is open. If the cube door is open, pulled a little stiffer than I expected in 1/6G.
Looking good though, Ed, and you all are within 9 minutes of the timeline.
Okay, we'll pick it up here in a little while. Okay, you ready for number one?
Yeah, number one, coming out.
Okay. And by I'm over overhauls in here.
Okay.
you're talking.
Pick it over. Hey, that's rough to find a level spot to put anything. Okay, number two is coming out. Hey, can you get that by yourself?
Yeah, I think so.
I'd be sure. Does it vibrate too much? Okay, and it's on the surface. Oh, all this beautiful white paint is sure gonna get filthy out here. Bend a little bit, I just can't bend out to that. Carrier's clear.
Roger.
You never appear.
Nothing yet.
I fully expect to see Earl and Ron come running around to pick up the pit bins and the thrown away parts. Okay, and it's on the surface. Oh,
plane is sure going to get filthy out here. How much for the fuel cast?
Roger, Ed.
The fuel carrier, as you can undoubtedly see, is on the net, no problem.
Roger.
Okay, the temperature indicators on the mast show that there's been no heat.
Roger.
And the cast is coming down.
Roger, Ed.
And it's down for us, I believe. Okay. If we can get lid off of it. Light slope is about as little as we can get from here. Okay. Okay, looks good. All right, still more this way. There you go. Very good. Houston, all of the temperature indicators are still white.